Hello student, welcome to Standard 9 Geography. Let us continue the lesson 2nd of Geography, Endogenetic Movement Part 3. In the previous lecture, we have seen how block mountains forms, and we have also seen their example such as Black Forest Mountain and Meghalaya Plateau. Now, in this lecture, we are going to study the Rift Valley. Let us do this activity together. Take three notebooks of the same size. Hold them on tightly on a table, keeping a distance of 2 to 3 centimeters. Remove the two notebooks on each end away from the center. Observe what happens. Draw the diagram emerging because of the notebook in your table, in your own notebook. So see this diagram, how it happens. Try to draw it. Let us see the geographical explanation. When horizontal movements on the Earth's surface act in opposite direction, it causes tension on the rocks in the Earth's crust. So horizontal movement causes tension on the rock of the Earth's crust. When tension increases, fractures develop in the rock. Naturally, the cracks are developed, the fractures are developed. This leads to formation of faults. Consequently, rocks on both the end slide, and the continuity in the layer of the rock is not found. So a rock which was same, it doesn't look same. Sometimes it is uplifted or sometimes it slides down. So let us see how Rift Valley takes place. Sometime two fractures develop side by side in the Earth's crust. The land in between the two fractures subsides. It moves down, it goes downward. This subsided deep part is called Rift Valley. See figure 2.10 A and B. Both the slopes of the Rift Valley are steep. For example, the Rift Valley of River Narmada in India, the Rift Valley of Africa, the Rhine River Rift Valley in Europe, that is the Great Rift Valley of Africa. These are the two examples over here which we are given, and one is found in our own country, that is the Rift Valley of River Narmada. Let us move on to next topic. So continent building or epiorogenic movement. Epiorogenic movement or continent building movement. Slow movements occur towards the center from the Earth center towards the Earth's crust. Because of this movement, a vast part of the Earth's crust is uplifted or gets subsided. So either they come up above the ground level, or they subsided below the ground level. When the part of the Earth's crust is uplifted, when it comes up above the mean sea level, continents are formed. Therefore, these movements are called continent building movement. Extensive plateaus can also be formed because of such movement. If the originally continental portion of the crust subsides below the sea level, it forms a part of seabed. Sometimes it goes down, subsides down, and then it forms the seabed. When it comes up, it forms the continent, or it is also called as plateau. So, continent building movement. Extensive plateaus are formed. We are at present on the Deccan Plateau. It's the extensive plateau here. It is divided into three parts: Maharashtra Plateau, Karnataka Plateau, and Telangana Plateau. Let us move on to next part, that is sudden movements. In the beginning of the chapter, we have discussed and studied the news item on earthquake. Earth means the ground, and quake means trembling, shivering. Earthquake is the movement of the earth's crust. You have been acquainted with the magnitude and effect of the earthquake through the activity at the beginning of the chapter itself. Now we will look at the sudden movements called earthquake and volcanoes in the earth's interior. Do you know? When you stand on a railway platform near the railway track, you experience trembling if a train passes by speeding. So the whole platform shiver or the trembles. Tremors are also felt near when a heavy vehicle crosses a bridge in speed. Through this example, one can estimate the tremor caused during earthquake. So this railway station or the bridge, when it shivers or shakes, it is on a small scale. But earthquake happens in the same way on a large scale. So let us study earthquake. Because of the movement occurring in the interior of the earth, tremors, tremendous tension is created in the earth's crust. When the tension goes beyond limits, the energy is released by the form of waves. This results in trembling of the earth's surface. So the whole earth's surface, because of this energy, is shivers. That is considered as earthquake. So earthquake occurs because of this tension. The magnitude of the earthquake is measured by Richter scale. Figure 2.11 is of Richter scale. Before that, causes of earthquake. Moving of the plates, colliding of plates, plates sliding one below the other, formation of fracture in rock layer due to tension in the interior of the earth, occurring of volcanic eruption. So our earth is made up of seven plates, and this plate collides, or this plate moves, and because of this earthquake take place. Please have a look of the seismogram. It's the machine, simple machine. The spring you can see, the heavy material, and the measurement of graph is done on the graph reader, and you can see downside the graph. Indo-Australia, Africa, Eurasia, North America, South America, Pacific, and Antarctica are seven major plates. The Earth's crust is made up of such plates. Oceans and continents are spread over these plates. Depending on the compression and tension formed in the interior of the earth, these plates move in various directions. So when this plate moves in various direction, the tremors received on the earth, and then we say that earthquake has occurred. focus and epicenter. Because of the focus, because of the movement occurring below the Earth's surface, tension is created and it keeps on accumulating. High energy is released at the place where tension mount up. So very high energy is released, and then this is the center of the earthquake. It is called the focus or hypocenter. So main focus is where the tension is mounting up and then it is released. Energy waves scattered in all directions from this center. The plates on the Earth's surface where these energy waves reach first is called as epicenter or the earthquake. So the moment the from focus the waves reach to the ground, that is called epicenter. It is the nearest place on the Earth's surface from the focus, and it experiences the first tremor. So it receives the first tremor. The epicenter is perpendicular to the focus. From focus, the 90 degree, it is when it comes to the ground, and it is closest region of the Earth. When the tension is released at the focus, the released energy travel in all directions. This energy comes towards the Earth's surface in the form of waves. These seismic waves can be divided into primary waves, secondary waves, and surface waves. So, three waves are formed through this tension, and they try to reach to the surface, or they travel in all the directions. Yeah.
So my dear students, in this part we have seen the rift valleys, that is Narmada Valley and the Great Rift Valley of Africa, Rhine Rift Valley. Then we have seen continental building movement, or it is also called as epirogenic movement. Then we have also seen sudden movements. Then we went and studied the earthquakes and the causes of earthquakes. We have also seen the focus and epicenter, the energy from focus which reaches to the ground for the first time in the perpendicular ways are considered as the epicenter. Because of this, three different waves are created, primary waves, secondary waves, and surface waves. In the next part, we are going to study these waves in more detail and their effects. Till then, goodbye and have a nice day.